Hey there, YouTube. Today I want to talk about something that kinda splits the elite community, and that something is premium ammo. First of all, I don't want to trash talk about premium ammo users, and I don't have a problem with commanders using premium ammo, but if I'm in doubt that my opponent does use it, I mostly disengage the fight for obvious reasons. But that's not what I want to talk about in this video. I want to talk about how this mechanic can be abused in a completely different way. And I don't even think that FTF themselves ever thought about it that way. But let's start with a question. How do you know if someone uses premium ammo? Well, sometimes it's easy and sometimes you just can't say it for sure. For instance, FTL with short range plasmas plus heat conduits can deal a huge amount of damage. On the other hand, FTL with long range premium plus heat conduits plasmas can deal a huge amount of damage as well. In these cases, it could be the range your opponent is shooting you from for you to kinda get if or if not he's using premium ammo, but you just can't say that for sure. It's easier to kinda see it against rails, especially for commanders flying without shields like I do. In that moment when a Reversky FTL hits you the second time with two rails and your first module reinforcement is busted, you could know what you're dealing with. But in the end, you still don't know. Because this premium ammo thingy is just getting more complicated the more you think about. In my opinion, and I want to say it again, I'm not a premium user hater, but in my humble opinion, that mechanic needs to get taken out of the game. Not because it's overpowered, but because of the opportunity it gives to a certain kind of commanders. It's no secret that cheaters exist in Elite Dangerous. Those you can easily identify as such and those you're never really sure about whether or not they are. Either way, FTF never really had a good solution against cheaters, hackers, and it always had been the job of us, the players, to catch or run into them, record and report them. And premium ammo is one easy way to give everybody a possibility to use cheats without getting caught, if you play it smart. There are some programs or trainers out there giving you a lot of options to tweak the performance of any ship you fly, having a little bit more power output, a bit more damage of your weapons, a little bit more hull or shields, better module protection. You know, a cheater could easily just give himself 30% more damage output and you just might think he's a premium ganker. And all this is a problem. Cheats exist ever since video games exist. And in a single player game, I don't really give a shit about whether or not developers care about them. They implement them in the first place, so... But in an MMO like Elite, developers should care about it. Developers should care about cheaters, hackers, they should think about what they implement in that game and if it is a free ticket for cheating. In the beginning of engineering, everybody could have said that they simply had a god role. And now they could say they use premium ammo. Tomato, tomato. I think it is time for FTF to reconsider some decisions they... I think it is time for FTF to reconsider some decisions they made regarding Elite Dangerous. And they really should step up and do something. Because it's about time for changes to happen. Tell me how you think about all that in the comment section. Do you use premium ammo? And if not, why? And for the end of this video, I have my first use of premium ammo for you. It was a very fun and interesting fight against an FTL and a vet at Jameson Station. My opponents went back to the station for repairs several times and came back fighting again, so I thought, why not try out premium flechettes? I hope you enjoy watching it just as I enjoyed the fight itself, so don't use cheats and fly safe, commanders.
This is a safe zone, Commander. Hostile action will be met with a lethal response.
anyway. Catch you later.
Catch you later.